Dallas, Texas, I am so psyched to be here today. Are you guys ready to change agents' lives? Okay, let's start it off with a little Eminem.
Look, if you had one shot, one opportunity, you seize everything you ever wanted, one moment.
That's better.
Yo.
Okay, guys. They cut it short, baby. So I'm Bill Price from Charlotte, North Carolina. We have one shot to change your lives. You have one shot to change your family's life. And EXP is your best shot. So take advantage of it. Are you guys ready to step on the accelerator and burn this to the ground? Because we have to work together as leadership and collaborate together if we want to be the largest real estate company in the world in the next 2 years. We can't do this alone. So I'm here today to share with you how Charlotte, North Carolina grew so quickly, and it's because of community. It wasn't because of one agent. It's because a bunch of leaders got together, they trusted each other, and they worked together, and they grew together as a whole. So where does it start? Starts with the introduction, right? We all got that phone call. We didn't want to go to that meeting, did we? Craig LePage and Shelly Johnson called me. They said, we're leaving Keller Williams. We're going to eXp Realty. And I was, where are you going? They said, eXp, come out for beer. I'm a cheap date, so I went out for beer. And so they started, and by the way, I'm sorry, I love you all, but Craig, Shelly, I love you guys. Best sponsors anyone could ever have. I love you too. So they started telling me about the virtual world, and it scared me because 2 months before, my wife multiple times had to sit me down and teach me how to attach a file to an email. But I was open to it. Then they started talking about how Amazon and Netflix changing the industry, and so is eXp. When they said Amazon, I can relate to it because every day when I come home, I trip over Amazon box because my wife's a platinum member. But when they said that, I'm like, okay, I get it. Okay. So then the light bulb went off. They didn't waste too much time. They knew me. They went right to the rev share. I said, wait a second. Are you telling me every agent that I bring over to eXp and they have a sale, I'm going to get a cash reward for it? They're like, uh-huh. I was like, well, hell, let's order another beer and fill out the application. I'm ready to go. I was their easiest recruit ever. I promise you that. So when I saw that, that was a booyah moment. What's a booyah moment? Do you guys remember the great late Stuart Scott? Yeah, baby, he's awesome. He changed the way sports announcers talked, right? And what's booyah mean? It's a celebration of something awesome. And guess what? I came home that night, my wife said, how'd the meeting go with Craig and Shelly? I held up my hand and said, honey, booyah. In the Price household, we actually celebrate booyah. And just to prove my point and show you that whatever, the walk, the talk, here you go. So there is my four-year-old son. It's not 20 years ago. He's four. So, yep. Yeah, at 51 years old, I decided, my wife and I, to have a baby. And just so you know, he also has a younger brother, so I must be crazy. So this is my son attempting a 12-foot putt in the backyard.
One. Go ahead, Cub. Take your time.
Booyah! Booyah!
Booyah! Nice job.
So we really do celebrate booyah, okay, in the Price family. Now, you guys are going to go out there. I was so excited to go out there and sit down with my first agent, right? Get him over to eXp. So many times I was like, don't forget, guys, 4 years ago, we only had like 3,000 agents, and people would say, ESP? I'm like, no, man, eXp. And then like 10 minutes later, they're like, I get what you're saying, but I never heard of ESP. And I would say, listen, for the love of God, if I had ESP, I would know exactly what to say to you. So You fill out this damn application, I can go on to my next agent. And it's okay, guys, to feel this way, because you're going to feel this way a lot.
till Monday.
Hello? Hello? Anybody home? Hey, think but fly, think.
I mean, really, I mean, okay, you're on the fence because you're at a 60-40 split and you're in love with your broker in charge. I mean, how many times do we get that, right? But listen, just move on to the next agent, okay? They'll come back to you. It's not if they're going to join, it's when they're going to join. Okay, so when I ask you guys a question for the next 12 minutes before they drag me off, I want you guys to scream back at me, booyah. You got it? Okay, let's give it another test. Now, how grateful are we for James Stroop and Rob for what they do for us? That's what I'm talking about. Now, do you guys want to know how to explode your business? I love it. See, we're having fun. Isn't this great? Okay, so you heard my micro approach. It didn't work too well, but we had to sit down with agents individually. So I said, I need a macro approach. I need to get agents quicker. My wife will tell you I have patience of a gnat, okay? I just want it faster, want it now. So I called up James and Brent. I said, hey, listen, man, you guys are doing those lunch and learns out there? Tell me a little bit about it. And they did. I said, it sounds like a wedding rehearsal dinner. I've been married 3 times. I could do this in my sleep. No problem. And guess what? We had 32 people show up. 12 people signed up right away. I was like, I like this macro approach. And it wasn't easy, guys. Back then, after we did the presentation, someone would say, how's your stock? I would say, don't have any. How's your rev share? Don't have any of that either. I said, but it's going to be great. You just have to have the vision to see it. I promise you, it's going to change your life. So the lunch and learns started working. And this was another booyah moment for me, the lunch and learn. It's when the I becomes we. Every realtor in this room right now probably thinks they're the best realtor in their hometown, and maybe rightfully so. But when it comes to building your organization, you cannot do this by yourself. You need to form a leadership pack with other realtors in your community and grow it together. I promise you that will work. So our first lunch and learn we had, it was Rich Tomasini, Bob Crowley, Tom Hawker. I said, guys, we did a good job here, but we need to expand. And we did. See all the red dots? We had 6 lunch and learns going, 2 on Tuesday, 2 on Wednesday, 2 on Thursday, for a whole year. And we needed leaders, so we went and grabbed Keely Taze, one of my strongest in my organization, Marcus Dilley, Kathy Burns. Kathy Burns, give me a booyah. There we go. And we were doing 6 lunch and learns a week for a whole year, and that's how we exploded. Well, then we said, wow, this is bigger than all of us. Instead of 10 leaders, let's get 50, because 50 brains are a lot better than what, 10. And we sat down, that's like the back room of Macaroni Grill, and guess what? We strategized and mapped out what we're going to do, not the next quarter, the next year. And one thing we said, we had to bring in the whales. What's that mean? It means let's get some of the big corporate people or big agents to come in and talk for us, because it's always good to hear it from someone not in your community. Our first whale was Jason Gessing. Jason Gessing comes in. Oh, yeah, love Jason. Jason comes in, and he's up on stage doing a great job, and he's using all these big words, right? He's a smart attorney. And in the back room, there's 2 realtors, and the one guy's like, what did he say? I don't know what that word means, but he seems really smart. I like it. I think I'm going to join. And we grew like 50 people that day. But, you know, it's smart to give the smartest guy in the room the microphone, and it's usually Jason Gessing if he's in that room. Okay, then we had Elvis came in, right? Brent Gove. Who, right? Yeah, booyah for Brent. Who better than Brent? He comes in like a tidal wave, so much energy on this stage. We all can learn from him, right? I try to learn from him all the time. He's awesome. But the biggest thing with Brent, I will tell you, people trust him, and people will follow him, and we're so lucky to have him. This room is like this right now because of these events that James and Brent put together. After that, we had Gene Frederick. Are you ready for Gene? So Gene comes in. I introduce him. He gets on stage. I go back to my table. I sit down. Gene's off stage. I'm like, where the hell did Gene go? Gene's over on the corner talking to some agents. He's like, oh, you've been married 25 years. I miss my wife, Susan, so much. I've been on the road for 2 weeks. And he's getting choked up. At that point, every woman in a room was in love with Gene Frederick. And then he gets up on stage. I'm like, okay, good. We're back to EXP Explained. I'm going to try to do my best, Gino. Gino gets on stage, and he's like, besides my wife, I miss my grandson. Okay, I miss him so much. He's bound for greatness just because of his name. And here's Gene. Are you ready? Do you want to know his name? His name is Lincoln Apollo. You imagine a name like that? He's going to be famous, this kid. Now every parent in the room loved Gene Frederick. And every grandparent. So I tell you this because when you're recruiting an agent, get to know your audience. And there's no one better at it than Gene Frederick. He got to know his audience. They loved him before he said a word. Then we had Sheila come in. Hey, how about Sheila, homegrown Dallas girl? Get a booyah. Sheila comes in, and we're celebrating the top female agents in Charlotte. We had a panel of about 15 agents, and it was great. It was an awesome time. They shared with everyone how and what they did to be successful in real estate. Now, I'm with Craig LePage in back of the room at the last event at Sheila's, and he looks at me, he says, who's next? I'm like, Glenn? And he's like, why not? I said, okay, I'll call Glenn. He actually picked up the phone, and I said, hey, Glenn, it's Bill Price. We're having an event in a few months. We'd love to see if you could come out. And he's like, let me check my schedule. He called back and said, Bill, I'm in. Then I hung up and said, holy shit, what am I going to do? He's actually coming, and this better be really good. So we looked at our leadership team, and we decided let's get Dave Kinnord and let's get Gene Frederick to come. It was an awesome event at Charlotte Convention Center. Glenn came, he got up on stage. You know, he had his stool and his laptop, and he just shared with everyone what the outlook for real estate was and how EXP fit into that and how it was going to change the way we sell real estate. He did not throw out any Kool-Aid. And so many agents the next day, the next week, said we really appreciated his approach. Then Dave Kinnord got up. He's always polished, the whole slideshow. He's great. Now it's Gene's turn. Okay. Gene says, Bill, I need a whiteboard, 2x4, an easel, and a marker when I get up there. And I'm thinking, there's 800 people in the room. What is he going to do? Sure enough, he gets up there. I sit down. He's on stage. I said, that's a good thing. And he tells everyone, I want everyone up on stage right now. And everyone rushes to stage. You know, that's just Gene's approach. And never second guess Gene Frederick, because the man's usually right. Can I get a booyah for Gene? All right, I love it. Okay, cross-organizational support. I will tell you this right now. You will not grow unless you get help from people outside your organization. So I called Jay and Ashley Nelson from Nashville, Tennessee. I said, I'm having Glenn Sanford come up with Dave and Gene. Just want you to know. He called me the next day and said, Billy, I am coming up with 15 agents. I'm a leader, and they follow me. Jay Nelson, let's get a booyah. That is giving back, expecting nothing in return. And how cool is this? When you get one of your own, they become a whale. A.J. Maida was brave enough 5 years ago to leave Keller Williams, go to EXP, grab Craig and Shelley, grab me, I grab Rich Tomasini, grab Keeley. We started working together, and we grew this. AJ now has over 4,500 people in his organization. He's only 34 years old, and you know what kind of money he makes. So all you single women out there, have bad news for you. There's a Mrs. AJ. She's beautiful, and they're very happy. AJ, can I get a booyah from AJ? All right. Okay, leadership, invest in yourself. Okay, you guys spend so much money on your own business selling houses. Well, how about putting them back in your organization? Because you need to. And share the expense. You know, my buddy Pat Hayes, right, in San Antonio, Texas, puts on a lot of events. Yeah, love Pat Hayes. But just because he has 4,000 people doesn't mean he has to pay for the event. I will tell you this. If you're going to do a lunch and learn, and you can do it all by yourself because you want to, you're going to have 5 people there. You get 10 agents working together, and they all have skin in the game, you have 75 people there. Even if they're not in your organization, who cares? You grow together. More people in a room, more heads are shaking yes. So we need to do something that was more than explaining EXP. So Craig LePage said, let's form the impact group, which we went and did. And we had a motto. It was basically support for people in Charlotte, agents, a landing page, where they could go. And we had a motto, and the motto was simple. We sell a ton of homes. We're number one in Charlotte. We have a lot of fun, and we change people's lives. We started education once a week, face-to-face. People felt good that they could go meet other agents, rub elbows. Not every agent can make it to a big event or even a lunch and learn. So Rich Tomasini, Tom Hawker, Shelly Johnson, and Meg Watson started doing Zoom calls every week. They've been doing them for 2 years. Started doing Superstar Series, got to interview a bunch of great agents. And one of my best interviews was with Jeff and Marcy. They're out there in Arizona. Booyah, Jeff. They're doing 600 sales a year. I mean, people want to know. I want to form a team and do that too. Now, we formed Realistic Realtors. We had to look out for the new agent. How can we get them selling more homes? So every week, we have a group of 10 icon agents, and we teach realtors how to sell more homes, right? We need that. And it's pretty basic, and we've been doing it for 2 years now every Wednesday. Now, we need a regional event. We reached out to Chris Bearer, at the time was a vice president of agent growth. And I want to tell you this. If you never heard Chris Bearer, get him to your one event. He is like Chris Rock. He's hysterical. Love the man. He's awesome. Then I think Shelly Johnson came up with this. She said to me, Bill, we need to have more fun. We set promise that. So she came up with the idea, double your sales, bring your family to the beach. And it worked. We went to Myrtle Beach with 250 agents. We had a two-day event. And guess what? It was awesome. Once again, what are we doing? We're building community, building trust with each other. Helps attrition rate, by the way. And that's really important when you want to grow. Okay, I'm almost done. We need a social committee. Lauren Rocca, where are you, Lauren? Booyah, Lauren. Let's hear it. Okay, that's Lauren Rocca is one of my best level ones, and she controls the social committee. So what have we done? We go to baseball games together. We go to whitewater rafting, Christmas parties. We're so big in Charlotte, we have two, one North Charlotte, one South Charlotte. Hockey games. You know, we go to these games. We don't talk real estate. We meet spouses. We meet kids. We bond together, growing our community, once again, collaborating as leaders. How about an escape room? Why don't you take 10 of your best realtors, your best leaders, and lock them in a room for an hour, see what happens. But you can have two leaders that don't get along, and they're going to work together because they have a mission to get out of that room before time runs out. Now, here's Cocktail for Closers. It always works. 100 people show up. Who doesn't want a free beer? When you guys are at these events, let your hair down. Have a good time. Don't talk real estate, okay? Maybe one time at every event, I have too many drinks, and I call my wife in the morning, and she hears that hangover voice, and she says, you've been out drinking with Jake Kinder, haven't you? Usually happens that way, okay? Now, last thing here. You come to these events because you learn something every time you come to an event. So an agent got up on stage and he said this. The next time you're recruiting an agent and they're on the fence, you look at them and say, I have a responsibility to make you realize what you're saying no to. Think about how strong that is. I have a responsibility to let you know what you're saying no to. Create a little FOMO. And who said that? Our very own Al Stasic. Al Stasic, let's get a booyah for Al. Okay, last thing, guys. And I want it really loud. Really loud. Are you ready to change agents' lives?